The mayor of Whoville, a man named McDodd, was devoted and fair and a little bit odd.
Good morning, Teeth.
Hello.
Would you like to be brushed?
Yes, we would, please.
All right. Perfect.
Citizens of Whoville, the mayor is about to brush his teeth.
All right. All those in favor of adding an extra Saturday, say aye.
Aye.
I have something important to say.
Mr. Mayor, you are out of order.
No, you are out of order. This whole council is out of order because Whoville is in terrible danger. We have been dislodged from our place in the universe. That's why we've been having tremors, snow in the middle of summer. But that's just the beginning. Soon we'll have gusty winds ripping roofs from our houses, earthquakes tearing up our streets, floods, more floods, tornadoes uprooting our truffle trees, complete devastation. And that is why we need to get every Who down into the underground storage area immediately. Oh, this is not working.
Mr. Mayor, are you seriously proposing that we spend the Whocentennial underground like worms?
No, not like worms. Worms are gross. You cut them in half and they keep wiggling. Oh!
Mr. Mayor, this council has had it with your idiotic rantings. And if there's any more talk of danger and devastation, we will not hesitate to remove you from office.
It'll be all smiles from now on.
Is that understood?
Yes. Our higher layer. Ow. Ow. That hurt.
The mayor of Whoville, a man named McDodd, was devoted and fair and a little bit odd.
Ah, look. They're going to light the Whocentennial torch.
Fish. Fish.
Can I borrow those?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and welcome to Rue McNett's Exotic Pets.
Right next door to Hiram Nauvoo's Edible Shoes.
Try my roast beast. It's for the Whocentennial feast.
Thank you, Mrs. McGillicuddy. Morning, Carl. You shouldn't have that. Any luck?
Not yet.
Hey, Mayor. A little help?
Oh.
As the mayor set off on his morning commute, he noticed things weren't quite the same on his route. The sky was all pink, the clouds were all swirling. The geese in the sky were just twirling and whirling. But please don't blame Horton, for he didn't know that a small bump above...
Grab this clover and I dope for it!
...was a big bump below.
I like it!
Hey, Mayor!
That was weird.
Hi! Good morning, Miss Yelp! Little goose trouble this morning! Ha ha ha! Ow! Whoa! Woo! They actually attacked me! It was weird! I mean, here you go, little guy.
Ow! Ow!
Go! That's sharp! The last thing you'd expect coming to work would be a bunch of geese. I know you know what I'm talking about. I can see it in your face. Well, I'll be in my office if anybody needs me. You can get all their names and write them all tickets for goose attack. I'll be in here.
I knew.
Thank you, Susie. Thank you, Susie. Yes, thank you. And that concludes our assembly. There's one more candidate. Jojo. And now our last candidate. Jojo.
You're short!
Ah.
Fellow students, I may be short, but I'm long on good ideas.
You just crossed the line, Horton, and I'm gonna make you pay. Terrible. It's absolutely terrible. We don't do things like that around here in this jungle. What are we going to do? We have to do something about Horton.
I told you to keep it to yourself. I told you.
Oh, hey, little fella. You're not so bad.
Horton, don't let us die! You're our only hope!
Horton!
I'm gonna make you pay.
Ba-ba-da-ba-da-bum. Hello, funny bird.
Ba-ba-da-dee.
Hello, poisonous plant. Da-da-da-da, ba-da-ba-da-bum. Hello, broken log. That I already passed. I just walked in a circle. Don't panic, Horton. Handle this scientifically. 1, 2, 3, 4, I won't be lost anymore. Well, glad that dilemma's over and done with. Hello again, poisonous plant.
I need to talk to my dad. Now!
Oh, JoJo, look at you! You haven't grown an inch since I last saw you.
Yeah, so I really need to...
I know what you need. A lolly. What flavor do you like? We've got blueberry, bananjerine, watermelon. Look what I've got. I've got strawbuncle.
Mayor, if the council doesn't believe Whoville could be destroyed, you have to have them talk to me.
What is going on?
JoJo!
Mayor?
Horton.
Dad, something big's happening. I just saw... Wait a minute. Who's Horton?
No one.
But you just called that horn sticking out of the drainpipe Horton.
Horton is... my horn! Everything in the office has a name. My chair is Charlie, my desk is Stan, Miss Yelp is Miss Yelp, and my coffee pot is Mr. Coffeepotamus.
Mayor, you have to tell the city council about me if it's the only way to get them to listen.
Whoa. Dad, Horton the Horn is right!
JoJo.
Whoville is in danger!
Mr. Mayor, the city council is ready to see you now.
Dad, listen to me.
JoJo, we are not doing this.
Here you go, sweetie.
Mayor? Hello? Is anybody there? So right about now, I really wish you were here to talk to me and take my mind off the fact that, I'm 1 week bored away from becoming the flattest elephant in the jungle. Well, I suppose things could be worse. Oh.
Now, burn it.
And the descent into total insanity begins.
Well, I guess this is it, Mayor.
Horton, how can I possibly thank you for all you've done?
I don't know, just, if you ever hear a voice calling from a speck, take care of it.
I will. Goodbye, Horton.
Goodbye, Mayor.
Horton headed back home, a big, sorrowful wreck, missing the friends that he'd made on that speck. And so all ended well for both Horton and Hooze, and for all in the jungle, even kangaroos. So let that be a lesson to one and to all. A person's a person, no matter how small.